Shit, almost out. Come on, come on, come on.
Whew, okay.
Got you. One of the camps can use this. Need this? See what I can do. Cope, this man I'm tracking down, who'd he kill?
Why do you care? It's just another bounty job, isn't it?
Now look, I don't care. I just want to know their names. Who, Cope?
One of them is a man named Randall. Been with the camp almost a year. I didn't know the other two. You want me to ask?
No, I guess not.
You find that son of a bitch, you radio me. Copeland out.
Could make something out of this. Got it. Gotta take a closer look. Fuel. Where? You're mine now.
There he is! Silver helmet, red gas tank. That's him.
You can't get away from me!
The hell? So you thought you'd ride into Copeland's camp, shoot the place up, that about right? Kill a few folks, take some shit, just ride out, and just chop it up. Myself, if you want to know the truth, give Drifters a bad name. What if you'd shot Manny? You know, who'd fix my bike then? Stupid piece of shit.
Screw you! You
are a Copeland's toadies. You little bitch! That's what you are! You little bitch!
Cope, it's done. Got him.
You
mark down these coordinates and send your men out here.
You hear me?
Is he alive?
Hey, Drifter.
Yeah, Drifter. He's alive. But I won't promise you how long he's going to stay that way. Deacon out.
You tell him. Drifter, you tell him I said go. You go screw himself.
Boozer, you there? I was just calling a checkup on you.
It's a Drifter. Let him
in. Deacon.
You hang in there, buddy. As soon as we get that arm patched up, we're riding north, just like you said.
Ah, I hope so. God, I miss the open road.
You just work on getting better. I still got some work to do on the bike, and we gotta stock up on some gear. But once you're patched up, we're out of here. Deacon out.
Oh, yeah, that's a good piece.
We're never gonna finish this trap.
Look me up if you need anything else.
What do you need?
All right, see you, D.
You got something to say about it. That's it.
Hey there.
How's it going?
Hey, see ya.
I'll be by later.
What do you need?
Hey,
can I help you?
What? Not enough credits?
All right.
Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Broke another goddamn razor this morning. In our supposed global utopia, instead of getting the best products from around the world, we got the shittiest products cheap foreign labor could churn out. Everything in the last 50 years was built to break, so that you could buy once, buy again, buy. You always had to get the new car, the new phone, the this and that, all to feed the beast of crass commercialism. You want something built to last? You couldn't go overseas, nope. You need real, hard-working Americans at the helm. When we build something, it'll stand the test of time. And the same hands that built this country, they'll withstand anything this new world throws at us. Our roads bend, friends, but they do not break. And neither will we. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
They look pretty broken to me, Cope, but hey, whatever you say. There's nothing wrong with a little crass commercialism. Hell, I could use a new bike right about now.
So close to O'Leary Mountain. Don't ask me how. Which way? Still got this. Okay, let's take a look around. This way. This is it. If they left anything worth the effort. More bounties.
Who's that?
Always need ammo. I gotta clear them out. I gotta make it safer to ride through here. Smell it. Gotta be getting close. There's another nest. Let's burn it up. Doesn't look too bad. Let's go.
Awesome.
Now I got you.
That should be it.
We're just getting started.
Thank you. Weeping Angel. This has gotta be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon?
Gotta take a closer look.
I never knew that. I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere.
I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Distract them.
else hear that? You must leave the area immediately, or we will open fire!
Stay low, stay low.
Make this easy on both of us.
I wonder how long this will take.
Too damn long. That's how long.
It wasn't even my turn on the duty roster.
Blame to the CO. Do I look like the CO?
Did you see something? Stop!
Hold on.
Entering a
we can be friends
area.
Now, can't we? Okay, stay low, stay low.
Shouldn't be too long. Doc knows what's up. You hear that?
We got enough fuel to get back. Going all over hell and back today.
We got plenty of fuel. I double checked.
field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey, Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Did you hear me? Over 400 subjects. And these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Slow my baby, sir.
And I asked if you were going in. Didn't say I was.
Subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like he was peeling. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. Not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Sealed caves. Yeah, right. Like anyone gives a damn.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Brian, you wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me.
I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some... Deacon out.
Against the feds? Well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call... ...about the bullshit and the lies when they saw it. I know, because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Okay, let's see. What's going on here? Back on track. Gotcha.
Needing this? Topping off.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free.
Yeah, no. Maybe another time, Cope. Don't worry, Alvarez. I'm not gonna leave you to the freaks. they can't get you now.
Boozer, you there?
Yeah, Deke.
I took care of it. Alvarez, I mean.
Thanks, brother. She'd do the same for us.
Yeah, she would have. Deacon out.
Open up. Don't get all day.
It's one of the drifters. Let him in.
You, need something, man?
Manny, I'm still not happy with you.
Can I help
okay.
you?
All right.
You got something to say about
it. How am I supposed to fix this piece of crap?
Looking for something in particular?
What's the problem?
What? Not enough credits? I'll be here if you need anything.
How's it going, Deke?
What's up, Manny?
We can fill your bike up if you need it. I wish I had a better set of tools. I'll be here. No, I'll keep an eye out for more shit.
What do you
see
need?
Around me?
Just looking.
Hey, Jesus, Deke. You hear what's happening? Black choppers. The feds are still flying. Can you believe that shit?
Wait, what? What are you talking about?
No, Cope won't shut up about it. He says it proves what he has been saying from the start, that the feds are behind this whole mess. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? All that conspiracy shit. You think he's right?
Copeland right about anything? No. But listen to me.
If you see a black chopper, a Nero helicopter, you let me know, okay?
Yeah, sure, Deke. Whatever you say.
You got something to say about it?
See you, man.
See you later. That's it for now.
Hey, Deke.
Hey, Manny.
Let me get the gate. Yo, you need a refuel? Oh, yeah, that's a good piece. Should have more stuff later.